All right, for your discussion boards, you need to select credible resources and use APA format for your references list and in your end text citations. So once you're in your course, your Blackboard course, go into the link that says Getting Started, click on that, and then you're gonna scroll down until you see course resources, click on that, and then scroll down until you see credible references. So for these references, you can use the Keiser University Online Library, you can use your textbook, any of these professional science organizations. You can also use .edu websites, just make sure the authors are credible and they do cite primary research experts. Be really careful with the World Wide Web because sometimes some of these resources are not acceptable in a college level course. Be careful with open source or open text sources as a possible reference that you want to use, because a lot of times this information is not reliable, it's unverified, people can change it, so be very careful. And do not use any of these resources listed here for the references in your discussion boards. So here's some more credible resources you can use for this class. You can scroll through that. And now let's talk about APA format for your references in your references list and APA format for your in-text citations. Number one, you're paraphrasing the information, so you need a reference and you need to provide an in-text citation. So in your references list, you must provide the author or authors, publication date, title of the article, and then the source. Did it come from a publisher, journal with volume and page numbers, URL, or DOI? If you need more additional information about APA format, use any of these sites here. So here's some common types of citations that you're going to use in your discussion boards. Yeah, say for example, you have a scientific journal article with one author. The full citation for the reference list, you're gonna list the last name of that one author, first initial of the first name, first initial of the middle name, publication date, the title, the publisher, and then that web URL or DOI if it was provided. In-text citation, the last name of that single author and publication date in parentheses. So your textbook, which has two authors you use, full text citation for your reference list, you're gonna list Cowan, M, period, K, period, and Smith, comma, H, period, R, period, because you have two authors. You want both of those authors listed in that full citation in your reference list. Publication date, the title of your textbook, edition, publishing city and state, and publisher. In-text citation in parentheses, last name Cowan, and Smith, last name, and publication year or date, and then the page numbers. Say you use a scientific journal that has three or more authors, and there's a DOI, or say there's a web URL. You must list all of the authors' names, last name first, first initial first name, first initial of middle name. They must all be listed in that reference list, all authors, three or more. Publication date, title of that specific article, again, where did it come from? It came, the publisher was a journal, volume number, issue number, and then you can see DOI or web URL. In-text citation for three or more authors, you must include the last name of that first author, et al., comma, period, publication date. Say, for example, you selected an article published with an institutional author, such as the CDC website, the WHO website, or NIH. Here you can list and see Center for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, publication date, title of the article, publisher, CDC, and then the actual web URL where the information was retrieved. But again, the World Health Organization, WHO, and National Institutes of Health would also act as an institutional author. In-text citation, in parentheses, CDC, and then the publication date. Say you have a reference with no author, no publication date. Full citation for reference list, unknown because there's no author, ND because there's no publication date, the title of the article, the publisher, URL, or the DOI. In-text citation, again, there's no author, so in parentheses, in quotation marks, the title, and then ND because there's no publication date. So if you have any questions about APA format or any resources that you can use for your discussion boards, please let me know.